As an Angular application grows over time, you probably find that you constantly need to refactor things so that shared concepts, logic, behavior, etc. can be reused. You build things, and then later down the road, you build something that needs to do something similar, and now you want to break out that concept so that it can be shared, right? Well, animations in Angular are the same. Once you start building and using them, you probably find that you need to use them in multiple components. Well, in this video, I'll show you how to do this. All right, let's get to it. Now, before we get too far along, it's important to note that I've already created several videos focused on the animation framework in Angular. They cover the basics of setting up and using animations in Angular, creating state-based and enter-leave animations, using the keyframes, query, and stagger functions to create more complex animation sequences, using the start and done animation events, creating animations that run in parallel versus in sequence, animating to unknown heights, and adding configurable animations with params. So if any of those concepts are unfamiliar to you, you'll probably want to check those videos out first so that you're not lost in this video. And to make them easier to find, I've created an Angular animation playlist to help, so check it out. Okay, enough of that, on to the example for this video. Here we have this application called PetPix. It's an application where people share cool images of their pets. As you click to look through the images, you can see the nice transition forward as you navigate to the next image. And then when you navigate backwards with the previous button, you can see that it animates nicely in the opposite direction. Now, if you want to learn in detail about how I created this animation, you'll want to check out my video on how to use Angular animation params, because we're not really going to cover the animation itself in detail in this video. Now, since we've created this animation, we've added the header to the application. And the header contains a hamburger menu. When we click on this menu button, we see our menu. So that's cool, but it doesn't look great when it opens. It would be better if we added some animation as it opens and closes, right? Since it's opening from the right side of the viewport, it would be nice if it slid in as it opens, and then if it slid out when it closes. Well, this is exactly what we're going to do in this video. But instead of creating this animation all over again and bloating our code base, we're going to take the slide left right animation from our gallery slider component and instead make it shared so that we can use it in both components. Okay, so let's take a look at our animation in the component TS. Here's the animation that we're going to move. When creating a reusable animation, we create it in a separate file that we can then just import from. So let's start by adding a directory named animations. Next, let's add a file named slide.animation.ts. Now let's switch back to the slider component real quick and copy everything within the transition function. Okay, let's switch back to the new animation file. When we create a reusable animation, we create it as an exportable const that we can then just import. So let's add a const named slideAnimation. Now to set this const, we're going to use the animation function from the Angular Animations module. This function takes in an array of animation steps, so we can paste what we copied from the slider component here. We also need to make sure all the stuff we're using from the animations module is properly imported here in this file too. Okay, at this point, we now have a reusable animation. But you can see that we have some params here that allow us to pass an enter start and a leave end translate value. But we also have a hard-coded scale value that works nicely in the slider component. But the thing is, we don't want our menu to scale at all as it animates. We just want it to slide in and out. That's it. So what I'm going to do is convert the scale to a parameter 2. Let's call it hidden scale. Okay, that's all we need. Now let's go swap this out in our slider component. We can start by removing everything within the transition function. Let's remove the imports that are no longer needed too. Also, we can remove the params object from the transition too, since they will now be part of the shared animation. Now to use our new animation, we'll use the useAnimation function from the animations module. And then all we need to do is pass this function our exported slide animation const. Okay, almost there. All that's left now is to go and make sure our animation params are being properly passed to our animation in the template. So both our leave end and enter start params can stay as is, but remember we added a hidden scale param that we need to set here. There. That should be all we need. Let's save and try it out. Now, if we got it right, the slider should work exactly as it did. So let's try it. Cool, looks right as we navigate forward. How about going backwards? Nice, looks good there too. Next up, we have the whole purpose for creating the shared animation to make our nav component transition as it's toggled open and closed. Let's switch to the code for our header component because that's where our navigation component is toggled. In the template here, we can see the condition using a show menu signal to toggle the menu. If it's true, it'll show. If not, it won't. Since our animation queries for elements entering and leaving, we'll bind our animation on this div here. Let's call the trigger slide toggle like we did in our slider component. It doesn't have to be named the same, but I like that name for this animation trigger. Now we'll want to run this animation every time the show menu signal value changes, so we'll use that as our value. Now let's add our params object. Within this object, we need our leave end param. It will be 100% so that it ends outside of the viewport to the right when it's closed. Then we can add our enter start param, which will also be 100% because when it's opening, it will start outside the right edge of the viewport too. Then we can add our hidden scale param. In this case, since we don't want it to scale as it animates, we'll give it a value of 1. Okay, now we just need to create and import our animation, so let's switch over to the code. First, we need to add the animation's metadata array. Within this array, we need to add our slide toggle trigger using the trigger function. Then we add our transition, which will run whenever the show menu value changes. Then within this transition, we can include the slide animation using the useAnimation function from the animations module. And that should be everything. So let's save and see if it works. Let's click the hamburger menu button to toggle the menu. Nice, looks like it's transitioning like we want now. What if we close it? Cool, that works too. So it's nice that we didn't need to create a whole new animation within the header component to pull off a very similar animation style to our image slider. Just like everything else, it's better if we can share and reuse similar concepts. So hopefully this will help you out as you add more animations to your Angular projects. Now, believe it or not, there's still more to Angular animations outside of all of the videos that I've already created on them so far. So we'll go ahead and call it for this video, but be on the lookout for more on animations in the future. That's all for now. Thanks for watching.